Better hits. Hi, I'm Tom Davis, sports editor with the News-Sentinel, and you're joined at newsentinel.com with Northside football coach Ryan Hall. And Coach Hall, last year wasn't really an eventful year for Northside football, was it? I mean, after all you did was beat Dwinger, you beat Snyder, had a great year, eight wins. How'd you do it last year?
A lot of hard work. Our team chemistry was great. Put in the work in the offseason. We have a talented senior group, but we also have a talented junior group that just combined together. And we really believed in what we were doing, and we worked our tails off, and it paid off.
Now, how's the offseason gone? Has that work ethic carried over into this the past 6-7 months?
Oh, definitely. I mean, the wintertime, we were great, and this the summer, with the heat and everything, we still worked every day. I think the expectation's been set, so the junior class took over from where the senior class was, so there's not been any drop-off when it comes to hard work and dedication. The kids are here every day. We don't have to go searching for them, ask where they're at, this and that. They're here on time, and they work as hard as they can while they're here.
Now, they always hear coaches talk about developing a culture around the program. Have you done that at Northside, that the kids know what it takes?
I believe so. You look at our quarterback, C.J. Jackson, who this will be his third year. Anthony Lanier and Russell Collins have all started for 3 years. So, since I've been a head coach, they've been starting for me. So they know what's expected. So when I say something, they're right on board. And then when they're on board, the rest of them are on board. So there's no debates anymore. We kind of all know what we're striving for and all know what we want. Hopefully we know how to get there.
Now, the big name on offense is C.J. Jackson, an unbelievable athlete, very productive for you last year. How is he better this year than he was last year?
Experience, confidence-wise, he can run our offense. Coach Mers is our offensive coordinator. He does a great job. Him and C.J. have a great relationship. But not to take anything away from Mers, but I think C.J. could run the offense if something would happen. He just knows where people should be. He knows what needs to be done. And I can go to him, certain situations. You think we can do this? Should we punt the ball? What should we do with the offense? And he's like my right-hand man. So just him having so much experience that he has right now is just tremendous. I think right now, we're not taking anything away from any quarterbacks. I haven't seen any young kids, but I think he's the best of all.
Okay, well, those numbers back that up. Who are some of the other offensively skilled players, running backs, wide receivers, that we can expect to see production from this year?
Can't forget about Anthony Lanier. He was a junior All-State, started with the Waste for us, ran for almost 900 yards, and also had 13 sacks on defense playing linebacker. Also came in third in the state wrestling too, so just a great athlete, one of the hardest working kids.
Anthony Lanier was so solid on both sides of the ball for you last year.
Yes, and we're expecting, he's working, he never stops working hard. He's just a great kid, he's got a good GPA, does great things in the classroom, just a great kid. And also we got Trevon Graham, who was at the second team all conference as a defensive back. He's going to still play defensive back, but we'll move him into a slot to catch the ball for us. And he can make some plays. And then offensively, Zach McKittrey will be playing wide receiver. Keon Brown's made great strides as well in this offseason. So we got some kids that are not as tall as our receivers were last year, but they're faster, they're smarter, and they have great hands.
But it all starts up front in the offensive success. So who's going to be blocking and clearing lanes and protecting C.J. Jackson?
I mean, we return both of our tackles, Marcus Moorhead and then Russell Collins. Russell Collins has put on probably 35 pounds since last year. He was second team all conference too. He's getting looked at by some of the MAC schools right now. Just his offseason has just been tremendous. He's weighing 265, almost 6'4" now. So we're really expecting big things from him. We're going to run behind him a lot. He plays left tackle, so he protects CJ's the passing lanes and all that. And then we got our other tackle back, Marcus Moorhead, who's also, this will be his second year. So we return both of our tackles, which is good. Then we're going to depend on some of our sophomores to play in the middle. We've got to replace both our guards and our center. They're big enough and they're strong enough. They just don't have a lot of experience. So we got to get them some game experience. And I think that whole line can be better than last year's.
Okay. Well, defensively, how about up front? Who's going to be the bigger names up front?
Yeah, Russell Collins goes both ways for us. So he made second team on conference as a defensive lineman. So we're expecting great things from him on the defense side of the ball. And then we also got Dustin Gregory, who's back from last year as well. He started for us. And then we have a new nose. It's going to be W.R. Sanders. I'm expecting really big things from him. We have to replace Marco Thomas, who's a three-year starter for us, and that's a huge loss. But we're going to go with a faster, smaller nose where he's going to be able to shoot some gaps and create some problems. So we're really excited. He's just going to be a junior. Played linebacker last year, but we're moving to nose. So those three are in the mix. mix right there with some younger guys back in the ball.
Okay, and then in the secondary?
Secondary returned 3 out of 4 starters, which is huge.
It is.
Teron Graham, which we talked about coming back, he had 5 interceptions in the return. Our strong safety, DeMond Gaston, with 3 interceptions last year. And Josh Fleming, our free safety, had 3 interceptions last year, too. So you combine those, that's 11 picks right there out of just those 3. So I think that's really the strength of our defense this year. I thought last year we struggled in the pass game. I think this year we'll be a lot better in the pass game, especially with all the 7-on-7s we've done this summer and having those guys back there.
Can this program win a sectional this year?
That's our goal. You know, everybody talks about how good we were last year and what we did. But me and the coaches, we talked, we really didn't do anything because we don't have anything to show for it. All we did, we had a great record, you know, best record in 20 years, they said. And we did beat Snyder and Dwenger and beat some streaks. But we didn't win any championships. So everything, our goal and everything we've talked about since December is championships. And whether it's an SAC championship, sectional, regional, we just want to win some championships in that tournament.
Well, with all due respect, Coach Hall, I got news for you. You guys did a lot last year. Northside football was back last year. Everybody in town was talking about it. And it's because this guy did a great job and those kids did a great job. So congratulations and best of luck.